Let's assume that now we want to make our application dynamic, because at the moment nothing happens when I click on this button and this text actually does not change. And let's assume that now, after every click on this button, instead of this text, I want other text to be here, and it will be button was clicked 2, 3, 5, 6 times and so on. Each time when I click the button, this will be changed and the counter will be incremented. Let's try to achieve that. First, we already have large text component and we could modify text here. And we could write here, button was clicked, let's say 0 times. And now I will definitely see such text here. But now instead of this 0, we need to insert value of specific variable that will be modified upon click on this click me button. And let's try to do following. Let's try to define new variable and let's call it counter. Let's define it here using let counter, and let's set its value to 0, this initial value of the counter. And here now as value of this attribute, let's use JavaScript syntax with string template literal inside of it. Let's first add here a pair of two curly braces because we are about to add here JavaScript code. And now let's replace double quotes here with backticks. Backtick button is located near button 1 on the left. And here replace this double quote with backtick as well, like that. And now in this template literal in JavaScript, I could insert any JavaScript expressions using following syntax. Dollar sign, let's do that on the place of the 0. Then pair of curly braces, like that. And here inside could be any JavaScript expression. And here I'll put name of the variable, counter, like that. And at the moment, value of the counter will be 0, this is defined here, and I'll see same result as before. Button was clicked 0 times. That's how we prepared the value of the text property in the large text to be dynamic. And actually we could verify that, for example, here underneath this let counter statement, we could increase the value of the counter by 1, counter plus 0, 1, like that. And now I'll see that button was clicked 1 times. And that's because now value of the counter variable is 1. And that means that the value of this counter variable at the moment when this large text component is rendered is equal to 1, because we modified it here. Now let's try to add onClickHandler to this button. And anytime when we click on this button, value of the counter variable must be increased by 1. Let's do that. In HTML there is such attribute as onClick, like that. But in JS6 there is no such attribute. And in JS6 all attributes are actually in camel case. And that's why here you see suggestion to use onClick, where C is capital. Let's use it, onClick. And value of this onClick attribute will be actually a function. And we could either define function before return statement somewhere here, or we could define function here in line. And of course, first we need to put here a pair of curly braces because we are about to write JavaScript code here as value of the JS6 attribute. And here will be error function, and let's simply print to the console button was clicked, like that. Now let's open up console here and try to click on this button. Button was clicked and you see here a counter that is incremented, and that means that each time when I click the button, this function is actually called. And that's why I see button was clicked here in the console. Great. Now inside of this function, we could try to modify value of the counter. Let's try to do that. Let me remove console log statement here like that. And let's try simply type counter plus 0, 1. We are incrementing counter by 1. Now let's try to click on the button, and I see same text as before. I still see button was clicked 0 times. Let's go to large text.js file, and here before return statement, let's write console log statement like that. And let's simply print to the console component was re rendered. Let's save changes, let's open up console, and let's click on the button again. I see component was rendered only once, but when I click the button, this large text component is not re-rendered. But actually, this variable counter is changed, and we could verify it here inside of this function. Let me actually extract this function and define it separately here. Let's define a variable const onClickHandler. Let's give such name to this onClick function, and its value will be arrow function without any parameters, like that. And here let me use body of the function, and let's again increment counter by 1, counter plus 0, 1, and let's also print to the console value of the counter, like that. And now instead of this function that was added here in line, let's simply add name of this onClickHandler, onClickHandler, like that. And now anytime when I click the button, this function, this one, will be called. Let's now test. Click once again, and I see counter that is incremented each time when button is clicked. And this means that this variable is incremented correctly anytime when we click the button. But this component, large text component, is not re-rendered. We don't see this text here in the console. And this is very important moment for understanding.